Hello, it's Mark here at Gary's Guitars, and I'm here to talk about cheap guitars. I'm hanging out with my cheap friends and talking about, there's a lot of interest in cheap guitars lately, why that is, and the attributes of the cheap guitars that people like and, of course, don't like. Those are a little more obvious, so let's get into it. There's been this new crop of guitars around that we've nicknamed Amazon guitars, being that people can buy a guitar on Amazon.com, shipped to their home for like $100-ish or something. And the most prominent of these brands are Firefly, which we see a lot of lately. And there's become, you can see these forums of Firefly owners who like to upgrade their guitars and, you know, take this cheap guitar and make it better somehow. And that's, I guess, part one of this whole idea is people just love to modify something, make it special, make it their own, make it better than it was before. When we talk about cars, it's true. When we talk about guitars, it's true. And these are good little modding platforms because they start out really cheap. Then there's another attribute to it. And I'll say this, if I take a step back for a second, there's three attributes to anything that's manufactured. One is materials quality. That's a little obvious. Two is workmanship, and three is design. Well, design comes first, so design, materials, and workmanship in that order. And guitar designs are pretty much set in stone. There's innovation out there, but there's a lot of great guitars that have already been invented for other people to base their designs on. So design in guitars is not quite a problem like it is in manufacturing other things. And a lot of these Chinese companies have been ghost manufacturing for other companies. Actually manufacturing for, Fender and Gibson and those companies. So they know what they're doing, a lot of them. And manufacturing quality in China in general has just gotten really good lately in a lot of spheres. And if you don't believe me, look at your iPhone. It's made in China. Anyways, so let's talk about design. We talked about it already a bit. They kind of use the traditional American guitar designs. Two, workmanship. Workmanship is kind of leveled out in different countries of manufacture and different kinds of factories because computer-aided cutting is available everywhere. Anyone can get a computer cutter and cut really precise stuff and make them easy to assemble. So, and then just general, this is being filmed during the pandemic, in case you didn't know. So there's this whole thing, supply chain disruption. Oh, but supply chains do ordinarily function great. And so you can get the parts to make your thing pretty easily in the ecosystem of supply chains. Ordinarily, there's been some disruption, but in general, the disruption shows up so much because it was so easy to source parts to make things. So, and number three, materials. That's not the order I said them in before, but so we got the workmanship, we got the design, but materials, often that's where the corners are cut. Low quality or lower quality woods, plywood of course instead of solid wood, there's different kinds of qualities of ply. But that gives these instruments a certain attribute. There's one local player came in to get, he said, can you restring this and set it up, And it was a Firefly, and okay, sure, man. And I knew he was playing a show that night, and I was like, hey, you playing this at the gig tonight? He's like, oh yeah, I love the sound of this guitar. And I was like, what? I know this guy owns a lot of great guitars. He's going to take the Firefly to the gig. But I kind of know what he's talking about. They have a unique, hollow kind of sound. Lots of string sound, not a lot of resonance getting in the way. Because of the way that they're put together and the inexpensive woods that they use. They use walnut for the fingerboards instead of rosewood or any of those harder woods. They use kind of second tier materials, and it yields an interesting result, and some people really latch onto that. Most notably, recently Genesis was doing their farewell tour, and Mike Rutherford was playing Squire guitars. and he swaps one pickup in them, and that's it. Otherwise, he just uses the Squire guitar. And so I have a Squire right here. This is a Squire Tele. And let's talk about this for a minute, because people love these, especially for a modding platform. So we're going to talk about this and the attributes of it. So the body is thinner than a Tele, and you can't quite tell by looking here, but yeah, it is definitely it's a thinner, could even be smaller, but definitely thinner, lightweight body. These can use any number of pieces of wood glued together to make, you'll never see a natural one of these. If you were to strip this thick epoxy paint off of here, you would see just whatever wood. Some guitars, I've seen cheap guitars made out of particle board or, you know, some kind of that stuff. Of course, you know I love Dan Electros, or if you know me, you know I love Dan Electros, and those are made with incredibly cheap materials. So cheap materials can be cool too. The necks have this very satin epoxy finish on them. It's almost a very different tactile thing. A lot of people like the feeling when they play like that. When they just put their hand on that. Ooh, I like that neck. Okay. People are like, oh, I don't like smooth necks. I like the neck, you know, feels a little gritty to me. I like that. So, what else should I say about this? Now, the tuners and the these pickups are, generally speaking, they're usually ceramic magnets. Very different sound, very different pickup. The tuners are literally not that good, but they work. And that's an easy thing to upgrade if someone's going to upgrade them. And like I said, people like to get into upgrading these things and make them even better. There was a handmade guitar we had in here that was selling for, you know, a guy who makes a bunch of guitars, came in used. It had all the attributes, and I could have sworn he just took a Squire and did interesting things with it and called it his own guitar. Because it had that thin body, thin lightweight body. Maybe he copied it, but there's things about this that people really like. Here's the Fender Mustang. This is the cheapest. These now, street price on them is $199, I think. Street price on these now is, this is the Affinity series, and it's probably $299-ish. I don't even remember. Lots of price increases over at the Fender factory lately. But this was always, for years, has been the, you know, the cheap, cool guitar. Two humbuckers, once again, ceramic magnets. I can see from here the ceramic magnets. Some fit and finish issues. Sometimes you get fret sprout happening real soon, or just kind of uncomfortable edges in general. But the Fenders are pretty good with that. Their Asian manufacturing is pretty good in general. They've been doing it for long enough. They really know how to keep quality control right. Once again, a thin, lightweight body that in this beautiful Mustang elongated style. Thin, lightweight body that some people just get real comfortable holding. And this one's another example of kind of the cheapest. So there's no name on this guitar. Sometimes these guitars are made to have a name put on later by the third-party company. This has, if you look at this top, look at this interesting pattern on the top. This top is, I suspect, sublimated onto the top. So what they do on super cheap guitars, I've seen this on Epiphone or Les Pauls that are supposed to have beautiful carved tops. They actually take a photo of a beautiful top and they melt it onto the top of the guitar, and that becomes the finish. And it looks really cool. But then, if you look, it's actually just part of the finish. This is so bizarre, we might be able to see through that, you get the grain that's, the grain look that's been put onto it, and then a little bit of grain underneath it or something. It's because the materials aren't quite up to snuff, but the workmanship and the quality are decent. They're fun to play, they're inexpensive. You know, just get any guitar that inspires you a little bit, that makes you want to play it. It's worth having in your life. Now, I'm talking like a guy who owns a guitar store, but also I'm talking about someone who's been playing guitar for most of their life and just loves that feeling of, just any kind of music. Just getting in touch with the music in a certain way. And if a guitar helps you to do that, then it's good. So, let's see. Are there any conclusions to make? $100 guitars on Amazon are noticeably inferior. I would say get a Squire. But the Fireflies, people dig them. And that's all right. If you like the guitar, it makes you happy, it's a good guitar. Most of them are some kind of playable and workable. Beware of the degradation that might happen, especially an acoustic guitar that's that kind of cheap. You're going to have some, you know, bridge rotation right away and some top sinking. But that happens on Taylors and Gibson, so it's not exclusive to cheap guitars. So, that's my little cheap guitar spiel. Thanks for watching. Check out our other videos here on YouTube, and check us Instagram, and come to the store, and like, and all that kind of stuff. Come visit our weekly live show, and we hope to talk to you soon. Have a good day.